Assessor Lowell.
For me, this year, it's about us working together as a team.
Yes, amen, amen.
I mean, I could go on and on about the things in our personal lives that, especially that Brian and I have had that have been blessings. But for me, being in Sebring is about being part of this church.
Yes.
That's why I am here. I mean, my husband is here, and of course, you know, I transplanted here, but God called me to be here.
Yes.
And the most exciting thing for me this year is seeing our church start really working as a team. And for me, working as a team in this church, together, everyone accomplishes ministry.
Right.
It can't just be pastor.
Right.
It can't just be Sister Grace. It can't be just Sister Alice. We are learning to me this year, more in part, to work together as a team to accomplish the ministry that God has called us all out to be here for.
That's right.
I mean, ultimately, in the end, it's not even about us. It's about being called to be disciples.
Amen.
For Christ. And ultimately, in the end, that's what it's all about. And together, we are all beginning to work as a team in a way that I've never seen this church work before. Now, granted, I've only been here for almost 4 years, but I've never seen God move in this church like He has as we made the commitment this year, not just to build this facility. And boy, God is really sometimes the jokester. He has worked so many things out of so many of us just in building this sanctuary. It's absolutely amazing. You know, there was this saying, three frogs make a decision to jump off of a fence. How many make that commitment?
There you go.
Three frogs make the commitment to jump off the fence. Yeah. They make the decision. We're going to jump off the fence. Now, naturally, you would think, well, of course, the three frogs jumped off the fence. Just like we're talking all the time, there's that little fine line, and you're teetering to and fro, and like you're on that fence, and you're going this way, and then you're going that way. But how many really did jump off the fence? It was zero. Just because they said they made the commitment doesn't mean they actually made the commitment to do it. You have to take action to do that. And this year, our church has collectively made that conscious decision. And every single testimony I hear from everyone, that they have made that conscious decision to start getting off that fence and make that decision. And to me, that is so incredibly powerful. Because we can listen to the sermons, we can listen to all the testimonies, and say, oh yeah, today's the day. I'm doing it today. But when we walk out those doors, are we still standing on that fence?
Yes.
Or are we actually taking action? Are we actually putting our faith into practice?
Yes.
And I see our church doing that.
Yes.
I see our church looking at our personal faith in God and starting to take those leaps and starting to make progress and starting to commit themselves, not just for ourselves, but to be able to do it on the outside. Ephesians 4, verse 16, from whom the whole body fitly joint together and compacted by that which every joint supplieth, according to the effectual working in the measure of every part, maketh increase of the body unto the edifying of itself in love. But then going back to verse 14, you know, they always say, Pastor always says, go back a couple verses. And this is where I think we're finally reaching that threshold, and that's where I'm excited, Pastor, because I see us getting past that threshold.
Yes.
Amen.
That we henceforth be no more children, tossed to and fro, and carried about with every wind of doctrine, by the sleight of men, and cunning craftiness whereby they lie in wait to deceive. But speaking the truth in love, may grow up in Him in all things, which is the head, even Christ.
Amen.
I'm just so excited. I am so excited. I'm just like going crazy. Not just for this brand new facility, which I mean, this is God. For us, a small congregation like us, with so few professional people. Yes, we do have some professionals in here, but they're not professional contractors. They're not professionals and be able to come up with these designs. This is God that brought this about. And I guarantee that as we continue to put that faith into practice, I can't wait to see what happens in this church. Amen. I am so excited to see what God is going to do. You know, as Pastor said, it's a remnant. We're not going to be that mega million-dollar church down the street or the one around the corner. I don't want to be those churches. I don't want to be, because those churches, eventually, when you get down to the nuts and bolts, don't have the foundation. I don't see the foundation in those churches. But I am happy to be part of the remnant. I'm excited to see what's going to happen in the future for our church. And I just want to say I'm thankful to be here.
Amen.